There is a button. This button is at the top of your Excel spreadsheet. This button is called Custom Views. And this is an Excel tutorial from Computer Tutoring. All right, so we've got our Excel spreadsheet here, and you can have a look on the screen. It comprises of a few sheets. I've got a revenue analysis sheet just here. I've got a quantity analysis sheet here with a nice little pie chart and a couple of pivot tables and a nice slicer here at the top. All right, I've got the data as well, where I've got some data I can type in book and DVD sales, and there's different filters as well at the top. I can click on the filters and I can just filter different years as well. If I'm just looking for 2019, I can do that and just see if I can get 2019 sales as well. If I want to, I can clear the filter as well. If I'm just looking for a particular category, I can do that. So if you haven't seen how to do that, then there's plenty of other training courses that we do at Computer Tutoring that you'll be able to see. But this time we're going to have a look at custom views, and in particular how you can use custom views to get the most out of your spreadsheet. And a couple of problems as well with custom views. Okay, so what I'm going to just do is clear the filter. It's nice. I like to go into data, and then there's a clear option just at the top here, and then clear the filter. So say, for instance, that you're constantly going around your spreadsheet looking for particular views. For instance, say, for instance, like you're scrolling down and you think, oh, you know what, I need to freeze the pane. So you're clicking here, you go to view, and then you're going to freeze panes all the time, and then you go to freeze panes, and yeah, that's good. So that's a good view. But then maybe you're turning freeze panes off some of your time. So you want to see a view like that. Maybe you want to see a view at the bottom of your spreadsheet. Or maybe you don't want to see the data at all. So you want to hide the spreadsheet, or unhide the spreadsheet, basically. I mean, there's very lots of different options to custom views here. So you just want to maybe make it easier for people to be able to access your spreadsheet. So this is what we're going to do. All right, so the first thing is we're going to click on the View tab here at the top of the screen. Let's just zoom in a little bit so you can see there. So up here, you see the View tab just here. Okay, so we're going to give that one a click. So click on View, and then all the way across, and you can see Custom Views just here. We're going to click on Custom Views. I'll highlight that in pink, really emphasize that there. So that's what we're going to look at, custom views here. And there's our custom views window has appeared just here. So what we're going to do is we are going to add this view, the total revenue analysis view. Let's just zoom out so you can see. Which way to zoom out? I always forget which one. Let's do that one. Oh, wrong way. So there we go. So what we want to do is we want to make sure you can see this first and get it all set up just right. I've got this on the view of 120. And incidentally, if you want this sheet so you can just see this data and maybe pick apart the pivot tables, you might find them handy as well, then I will make that available on the link below. Great. Okay, so on the custom views here. So what I want to do is click on the Add button just to add in a custom view. So I'm going to click on this Add button just here to add in a custom view. So there we go. So what I need to do is I need to give this view a name. So what I'm going to do is I will call this one Total Revenue Analysis. Seems good. I click on OK. That's good. And then I've got myself a custom view. If I zoom back here and I click on custom views here again, I can see my total revenue analysis. I've got that one there. That's good. Excellent. So what happens, and basically the way this works, is if I'm sort of going around here and I'm just mucking around with data here and zooming in and zooming out. Can I zoom in? Here we go. Or zooming out, I can use a little slider here, or I've got a touchpad at the moment that I'm using, trying to sort of get used to it, and think I'm going to go back to a normal mouse here, I think. There we go. Excellent. So you're just mucking around with the views a little bit here. If you want to get it absolutely precise, maybe 132, I can go here and that's it. Type in 132 and just to get that precise. That's great. And I can make another view here and set that one up. What I can do is go back to custom views, click on total revenue analysis here, click on show, and wow, it goes straight back to total revenue analysis. So I can muck around with that. So far, so good. Brilliant. Excellent. Let's actually just go back to the other view. If I go to quantity analysis, we can practice with this custom view. I think if I just zoom in here, if I remember, double click, get that nice Windows bling sound there available. That's good. Let's just zoom up here. Yeah, that looks good enough. Yeah, it's not too bad. I'm going to just save that as a custom view. So I can click on custom views. I can click on ads. And I would call this one quantity analysis. That's good. Brilliant. So far, so good. Just one little quick tip with this. The first thing that really we should have done, apologies for this, but it's not too late to do this, is we need to create a normal view. So if you go to data just here, maybe this is the normal view that we want to see, the view that we've got filters, etc., and scroll and up and scroll down. So we'll do this. Click on custom views here again. Click on add view. And we're going to create normal. So you need a standard view, a normal view, or whatever you want there. So there's many things you can do with custom views. Give you an idea, if I'm scrolling down and up here on the data here, I might want to freeze these top five rows here. So make sure that you click on A6. So just zoom in so you can see that one here. So if you click on this cell here, A6, and what happens is it will freeze everything above. So it'll freeze everything above A6. So basically A5 to A6, it'll freeze that there, basically. It'll sort of freeze everything from A5 up to A1. There we go. So it'll freeze all of that. So make sure you've got A6 selected. That's good. Let me just zoom out as well. There we go. So you've got A6 selected. Then what we can do is we can go to freeze panes, and then we can go to freeze panes here again. And then you see you're scrolling down and it's, you know, it's got all those top rows frozen, which is pretty good. But instead of having to remember each time to go back, we can create a custom view. You've got it. Click on custom view, click on ads, and we'll call this one freeze data columns. That seems good. Great, and you can go on, and you can freeze different stuff. I mean, one nice thing, say for instance, you don't want to see the data, you want to hide this. So if I right click and hide, and then go back to revenue analysis here, and I just want to see the revenue analysis here with between books and DVD. Incidentally, if you've got a slicer up like this and you want to just see both of them, if you hold down the control key, you can see, control key, yeah, you can see both of them there. So I can see books and DVDs. Okay, so that's what I want to see. That's great. Now I'm going to create a new custom view. And then what I'll do is I will add that one and I will just say pivot tables only. Okay, I've got a couple of little buttons just here, incidentally, where I can decide whether I want to include the print settings. So you can set up a custom view for particular print settings. And also if you want to do the hidden rows, columns and filter settings as well. So that's for the drop down filters. It doesn't seem to work within the pivot tables. And there's another little issue as well that comes up with that. So we'll come back to that little issue in just a moment. So we'll just do that. Okay, click on okay. And that's great. And so now we've got this custom view. So if I go back to custom views here, I've got different options. If I went to normal, I can click on show and I've got my data all ready to go, you know, here. And if I want to go back to custom views, I can change my custom views in this way. Brilliant. So what else can you do with that? Well, you might notice that at the top just here, if I just zoom in a bit so you can see. So just up here at the top, I've got a little drop-down list here. I've added custom views to my quick access toolbar. Now you can only add them with later versions of Office, so I'll just try it out if you can too. I've got Office, it's the equivalent of 2019, Office 365. So just really see if you can add it. So if you're thinking, you want this really cool drop-down menu here where you can say quantity analysis and it'll take you straight to the quantity analysis. Let me just zoom back so you can see the whole lot there. There we go. If I do another drop-down list and freeze data columns, it takes me to freeze data columns. If you want to see this really cool drop-down menu, you do the following. What you'll do first is you will go to this tiny drop-down menu to the right, which is the quick access toolbar. We'll scroll all the way down to and click on more commands just here at the bottom. What I like to do is at the top here where it says popular commands, click on that drop down list and choose all commands. Then just click once anywhere in the box below and just quickly type CUS like custom. And then as you scroll down here, I don't know if mine's here. I'll tell you what I'll do is my custom views is already here. So I'm just going to click on that and remove to bring that back. Just to pretend I haven't got it. Then if I go down and if I find, I should find custom views. And it's this one here, the one that looks like, that's it, with a little drop down menu to the right hand side. So this custom views, this one just here. So you can double click on it or you can click on it and then click on this add button just up here. And that will bring that one across. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to click on that, click on the add button here, and it brings custom views across. That's great. So I can now click on the OK button on the bottom right hand corner. That's good. And then you should have now this little drop down menu. It's really cool. At the top here, you can click and you can just go to quantity analysis. If I want just the pivot tables only, I click on the pivot tables only. And you know, it's a great way with custom views. That's great, really good. I mean, custom views work with filters as well. Let's just take us back to the freeze panes or the freeze data columns. That's a good one there. So if I go freeze data columns, I can have a look here and I can look for a particular contact name. If I just type in Andy here and press enter, I can do all of this and I can save that as a custom view. Different filters I can save. If I go to add and I say Andy's orders, I think I can have an exclamation mark in there. It seems good. Notice I've got the exclamation mark. We'll just find out if we can have that. Let's click on OK. That's good. Let's just choose another view. So if I go up to my newly acquired drop-down list at the top, go to total revenue analysis, that's great. If I can click on the drop-down list here and these orders, yeah, and you see it's filtered there. Excellent. Now there is a couple of downsides with this. The pivot tables don't seem to be able to filter using the custom view. So you can't use it with the pivot tables. If I just come back here and if I said I do books and then I want to go, okay, let's custom analysis and I'll say quantity analysis books. That's great. And say I'm on DVDs here and then I think I want to have a quick look at the quantity analysis books. I mean, I can go away here, come back to quantity analysis books, but I'm still got DVDs. It doesn't seem to pick up those filters that I've applied inside the pivot tables. And the other side of that one is also if the data here was a table. So if I went on here and some of you, if you've been following some of my tutorials, will know that tables are really cool. I can format this all this information as a table, which is good. Excellent. So once I've done all of that here, notice that when I go to my views, just here, you see the custom views is grayed out. I haven't tried the drop-down menu. Let's try that one here. It might work here. Let's see if we, no, you see, it just doesn't, total revenue. It seems to be something with the tables interferes with those custom views. So in fact, I was looking on the Microsoft site, if I go over here, it actually starts off this, and you can see where it was created, 2013. And why does the custom views not work with Excel 2013? And I come up here, it says, so 2 years rollout of Office 2016, many upgrades to 6.6.5, still no resolution. This is ridiculous. I tend to agree with this. So, you know, how satisfied you are with the response always is a wee one. I'm just going to, I'm going to just give that one there. Yeah, I'll just give it a three-star rating. That'd be good. That's good. I don't know if I'm logged in with that, but I would give it if I was. Great. It's good. Okay. So let's just swap back to the Excel here. So there we have it. Custom views in Excel. Really powerful. You can't use them with tables and you can't filter them with pivot tables, but I think you will agree. Let's just turn this table back into a range here. Convert to range. Yes, as soon as I do that, convert it back to range, go to my view here, and way, I've got my custom views back again. Yeah, I can go to my pivot tables and show and that, and I've got my pivot tables back, and yeah, great, brilliant. So if you haven't already done so, please click on the subscribe button so you don't miss any tutorials. We do tutorials in various software applications. If you've got anything out of that, oh, and also click the notifications button as well. There's a little notifications button next to the subscribe button so that you don't miss anything. If you've got anything out of this, then please give us a thumbs up. Really, really appreciate it. And I just really wanted to say thank you so much for watching.